Larimer County Search and Rescue, also known as LCSAR, is an all-volunteer search and rescue team whose mission is to find the lost, rescue the stranded and injured, recover the deceased, as well as educate the public on wilderness and mountain safety. Today's excursion is a field session training for avalanche response. Upon arrival on scene, team members must first assess safety so as to not put responders at excessive risk. First into the debris field are those searching for subjects properly equipped with avalanche beacons. Avalanche beacons are the most important piece of safety gear when in potentially hazardous terrain, so that in the event of a slide, those nearest have the best chance to find whoever may be buried before suffocation takes hold. However, as seen here, an avalanche probe as well as snow shovel are equally indispensable. Once a beacon has been pinpointed, avalanche probes are used to determine the exact point to begin digging, and then a proper avalanche shovel is necessary to chisel through the concrete-like debris, uncovering the buried subject. In this instance, the buried subject is a backpack with the beacon stuffed inside. In the event of an avalanche, it is not uncommon to have multiple subjects buried by the same slide. Here, another group of SAR members pursue additional signals from beacons which are buried further upslope in the debris field. The beacon gets close, the probe hits closer, and then the shovel moves in for recovery. Repetition is key to hone any skill. Yet it is all the more imperative when practicing something which needs to be instinctual, so that when adrenaline gets cranking because lives hang in the balance, everyone knows and does quickly and safely what needs to be done. In the first 45 minutes after a slide, 2/3 of avalanche victims will die of suffocation, making the removal of any airway obstructing snow the subject's best chance for survival. During this practice, SAR members were able to recover 4 buried beacons in the relatively small debris field in less than 2 minutes. In a real avalanche scenario, the field would be larger, the debris would be harder, but the skill set remains the same. Hours of charging up and down a snowy slope, shoveling hundreds of pounds of snow, and other exhausting exercise involved in avalanche training makes breaking for lunch a most welcome reprieve, giving SAR team members a chance to rehydrate and refuel. Such activity, combined with the heat of midday, also necessitates some personal gear adjustments. Not only is personal gear adjusted, it is also shown off. The Float Backpack, manufactured by Backcountry Access, is a pack designed for snow sports in potentially hazardous terrain. Tucked away in the shoulder strap is a parachute-like ripcord, which when pulled, explosively inflates a high-visibility airbag stored tightly folded up in the top of the pack. The theory behind this is that in the event of an avalanche, the wearer may deploy the airbag, which will then increase buoyancy, and thus decreasing the wearer's odds of being buried in the avalanche. Although the gas cylinder is refillable at any dive shop, deploying the airbag is rarely demonstrated. After the break, team members went back to training. This formation is known predictably as a probe line. Extremely slow when compared to a beacon search, it is the last hope for recovering a subject before surrendering to the change of seasons and waiting for snow to melt. Not only does this technique rely upon the individual perceiving what their probe hits, but also the comparison of the probe's final heights. During an avalanche operation, observations such as found clothing, gear, tracks entering, as well as tracks leaving the slide area are mapped out to help ensure all subjects are accounted for. This information is also useful in helping find those who may have been buried without a beacon. After the full day of training, everyone headed out of the field for a debrief back at the trailhead parking lot. A quick roll call, followed by thoughts on lessons learned, concluded the day's practice. Days such as this help keep LCSAR volunteers prepared to respond to missions 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, and all at no charge to those in need.